So I was reached out to talk a little bit about TASBot. Of course, I'd be happy to, because who doesn't love TASBot? For those of you who don't know, dwangoAC is kind of like the mastermind behind the bot, but also the TAS speedrunning community as well. As if you've ever seen a run from Dwango or TASBot, you'd know that every time he goes up, every time he showcases a cool TAS at any sort of marathon, he always gives credit where credit's due to all of the people involved with not only creating the TAS, but also like kind of explaining what it is about the TAS that made it so amazing for what it is. Like, if I was watching an F-Zero TAS and didn't really understand that community, he made sure to go into depth to explain why it is exactly that beating these maps, confirming it on a real GameCube with, you know, TAS inputted inputs from the actual hardware, why that's actually a big deal that you're able to replicate that. And that's really cool to be able to learn. And I'll remember this probably forever, honestly. It was 2016. It was my first GDQ ever. I go to SGDQ, and it's my first time. Like, I'm new to Twitch at this point still. At this first SGDQ, we're hanging out in one of the rooms, and everyone's like, yo, TASBot's gonna come up and show us what he's doing this for his submission. And I didn't even know who he was at this point. So my first time hearing of TASBot, he comes up to hang out in our room and everything. And he was showing Mitch Flower Power how to TAS his own SMB3 ROM hack that he had been working on, a really cool Kaizo super hard ROM hack. I can't remember the name, but it did come out. It's the ROM hack by Mitch Flower Power that's, God, just so difficult to complete. But long story short, Dwango was showing us exactly what he was working on. But the one that stuck out to me was the three player, but same inputs, SMB 1, 2, and 3 runs that he was doing. So not only did he have what in my head was the most impressive thing I've ever seen, you watch this video and you see all three games completing at the same time, you know, making use of like screen finishes. So one game's done the level and every other game can move freely on inputs because that game's inputs don't matter. Not only do you have that sweetness, but he has also got, you know, TASBot there holding a grid of four controllers that all actually light up to show the inputs as they're being performed for the camera. It's the ultimate fusion of big brain energy and showmanship. It's just crazy. It's just crazy. Dwango's just a really good guy. I've got to meet him a few times. I'm not sure if he remembers me or not, but I've got to meet him a few times at a couple of events. Obviously, SGDQ 2016 being one of them, but also at a couple of Calithons. And it's always so cool to talk to him because you never really know what kind of guy you would expect when you're like talking about someone with such, you know, talent and everything, with so many cool abilities. And like, it's just so cool to see him be such a good family man. Like, he's always taking his kids around on cool trips, and he talks about them so much, and it's clear just how much he loves his family, in addition to how much he loves TASing and everything as well, because he'll talk your ear off about both. TASBot and Dwango together have done so much for the TAS community, but also so much for charity. I'm talking about all the times I've met the guy. It's been at a charity event. He takes time out of his schedule. He takes, you know, it's not like he's going to these events and rolling in bank. He's going to these events and organizing these TASes, which takes a lot of work. Like, these TASes take months to build, and he compiles all of these awesome performances from the different people in the communities while obviously contributing to them himself in different ways. And he basically choreographs the ultimate task performances for these charity events to help raise money for amazing causes like Doctors Without Borders or Direct Relief or Prevent Cancer Foundation. You know, all these amazing causes that benefit from these charity events. TASBot has had a big hand in raising some of the biggest totals during these runs. You know, everybody looks forward to the TAS block of GDQ. In full honesty, the best thing I can say is that, number one, Dwango is a really good person. And number two, TASBot is a really amazing performance. Beyond everything, it's almost like watching a musical. You watch a musical and there's so many moving pieces coming together to do this amazing thing. Just like TASBot, all these amazing creators building this amazing showcase, breaking games down to their most efficient state, and then showcasing it to us in an interesting way, presented not only knowledgeably, but entertainingly. TASBot's a performance worth supporting. So if you've ever enjoyed it, you have my Full endorsement. The man wearing a Bustin Makes Me Feel Good t-shirt. If Tassin makes you feel good, maybe you should feel good and throw a buck or two to TASBot.